Hey everyone, my name is Ejaz Hussain. I'm a developer architect for a company called Advani UK. I'm based in UK. I'm also MVP. Last year was my first year in MVP program. So today I'm presenting this session on creating a custom rich text editor part with Fluent UI and RoosterJS. So before we get into this one, I just wanted to go to the agenda. So we'll see what the problem I was trying to solve for one of my clients and why I gone into this route, and then why I choose the RoosterJS. And then we look into the implementation detail, demos of the feature, and probably the next steps. So what was the problem? So the problem I was trying to solve was I was using TinyMCE, which is really, really nice, rich text editor, extensible as well. But the problem I was using the open source free version, I think 6.something. But now I couldn't use that free version anymore. They said it's not compliant. You have to have a either licensed version, which is the latest, or which is, I think that they have a 7 or 8 version. I don't remember. In summary, we couldn't go ahead, and the license cost was too high in term of for so many users. So, and then we said, okay, if you can't use this one, is there any alternate approach? Is there an alternate available which can give us a similar functionality, and also can give us a full control over the source code, and we can build ourselves some of the plugin and meet the business needs. So after researching and going through it, and what I found is RoosterJS. So RoosterJS is a Microsoft open source project, and it's a framework independent JavaScript rich text editor. It is a content model base, so it's like the middle path before you actually change anything. You know, you have a content model base, and then modular extensible. You can build. It has a plugin extensibility. You can build your own module and plugins, and is open source, so you have a full control over the code base as well. You can download the code and make a changes and in your own copy and add your own functionality on top of that, what is happening. And that's what exactly I did as well, and I can show you in a minute. So we look into a bit more detail of what it's inside the Rooster. I mean, before I go in here, I can just show you quickly. Probably, I think the worth looking into this, what's inside the RoosterJS. We have a core packages, about 6 of them. And this is, I think, from the Rooster 9, the latest version, they have divide different functionality into different packages, like the core package, API, DOM, plugin types. But if you really need a simple straight away out of the box, you don't need to get all of the other ones. You can just get the RoosterJS and you can start using the editor. Again, it's just that you need a one div element in your JavaScript and call the RoosterJS, off you go. But if you need to build something on top of that, then you need the core API and all the other and plugins and types, etc. as well. It also has 2 extensions, RoosterJS color utilities, and it also has integration support for the markdown as well. So please do check that as well. So let me show you what it looks like out of the box. So if I go in here, so if I just move this guy on there, so this is what it looks like out of the box. So you can go into this one, RoosterJS, and it has this implementation, all of the main, the normally which you get out of the box, all of the usual stuff. For each text editor, it has some support for you can, if you expand this one here, and you can add some tables. You can, and there's some more context around the tables as well, add and remove, adding colors and etc. So this is out of the box, so you can play around, so you can go ahead and, you know, start playing with this one in here. And there are some links over there. I think it's really useful. This is like pointing to the legacy demo, but there is a wiki page, but most, which is, I'm not sure if they've updated, it's still pointing to the old one. But if you go to the reference one, API, RoosterJS API reference, you can go into the each individual module to get to find out what each method is doing and what the parameter you need and what, etc. So it's really, really cool. They have published this one here. Here's all the documentation for each method. It's really, really helpful for me as well. So yeah, that's, please check out this one as well. And then if you move into the presentation, so now from here, and then we thought, okay, this seems like a good, it's a Microsoft open source, is a rich text editor with JavaScript rich text. There's no more dependency apart from this one, and we can just build on top of that. So what we did is, okay, I decided to use created a SPFx web part with Fluent UI 9, the latest version, and then play around and see if I might be able to use this one and to build a web part which has this functionality. So today, it's a really basic kind of thing, like functionality. I have not added too many functionality into it web part, but this give you as a starting point, and then you can build on top of that what you want to do for your client. So let me quickly show you a demo. What it looks like, and then we can look into the next steps as well. So give me 1 second to show a... Right, okay, so if I added this... So this is what it looks like. So this is, as I said, I've just added, about 10 or 12 controls in the ribbon, but this will give you an idea, like you can start adding more functionality control in the ribbon as you go along based on what your requirement is. I think I'm also looking into some, as a second release, but I'll be adding a few more as well. So so yeah, this is basically rich text editor. You can move like headings, change the headings, font size, as you see. So inspiration was the out of the box. If you look at the out of box text web part, so this is where I my more inspiration come from. So you can see here, so they have a similar UI, and this is where my inspiration was, basically use the late the Fluent UI 9, so we can have a kind of a similar experience for the user. So in here, if I select an image, you can see every out of the box control to expand and set this height of the image as well. So that comes out of the box plugins available within. There are a few out of the box plugins available, so that's one of them. And then for the link, for example, if I want to add the link in here, it doesn't give you any like a UI kind of thing for your web part, so you have to build yourself, but it gives you the API function behind the scenes. So for example, if I want to add a link, I've added this popover on click of this My Dialog, so I can add some link here, let's say, and then it will add the link. So you can basically add your own UI, and depends what you wanna do that. So again, image, I can select some images. If I look at the recently, I think it's not in the version which I have last submitted to PNP repo. Last night I added this functionality, which is a source code. So, and I will be shipping this few more as well later in this month as well, another version for this one. So if I click on this one, and I could see the full source code here for, I just added the image, and it's basically used the Base64 to display this image. So if I, for example, I think the idea was to use this source code. Source code is, if I go ahead and add, get any let's suppose I have some videos to embed a part of my, I think that's one of the requirement comes from as well from one of our client. So I said, okay, I think if we have a embedded a video to embed, so how can we do that? So I'm going to just get the embedded code from the YouTube and I'm going to stick in here for the iframe. And you could see here your videos. I'm going to press save and see what it looks like. Right, so this is like a, exactly the same UI in the front end. So basically, so it's the same nice experience you see on the display mode as well. So so that's what it's the rich text editor. I can show you the quickly code. But before I show you the code, I think the link is already pasted by David in the chat for the repo. But let me show you the code. How did I implement that? And then we can see if you have any question. To start with, simple. I will go to my web part class. So where is data is being saved? I'm saving in the property pane. So if I just show you. This is my editor content. So in the web part property, I'm saving that data. So whatever the user is changing in the rich text editor, I'm saving into that one of the property called editor content. And if I go into container, and this is just usual stuff. So this is the main thing. So again, this code can be refactored to meet your requirement. So my idea was just to, you know, provide something to so you can start work on. So what we're doing here, if you start with, so first of all, if you go to the plugin, on the top, sorry. So there are some initial plugin, which is out of the box available in the RoosterJS. So auto format plugin, it has some hyperlink, edit plugin, paste plugin. There's some option you can define in the paste plugin whether you want to keep the source formatting out of the box or you want to use the target formatting. So it depends. So you can set all these in out of the box one. There is some table edit plugins. Okay, but I have not implemented the UI, so that might be coming in the later versions. Some watermark plugin, and there's markdown plugins and image edit plugin. So when you saw me expanding the image height and width, this is where it's come from. So there's a few of the plugins are available out of the box in the RoosterJS. But then what I did was I'd go and added my own two plugins. So if you can see on the left-hand side, I've defined, so this is a Roost, there's a two plugin, Rooster plugin and update plugin. So I've created these two plugins. So this is like a usual interface to create those two plugins. So basically you can, on plugin events, you can pick up like on certain type of event, what your plugin, you need to handle some tasks or which when user performs certain tasks or press a certain button, then you can pick up those plugin, look at the plugin events and do any further processing on top of that. So so after initializing, if I go back to Rooster, my main class, okay, so if I, so after defining the plugins, this is the main thing with the in initial one, in the first part of the load, I'm defining, okay, this is my default format, this is my plugins, and this is the initial model which I'm creating from my HTML, which is actual, you see the HTML in the editor. So this is my initial editor initialization, and then this is where you're initializing the editor, Rooster editor, based on which div. So you need a div reference to give him a reference and the option, and that's it, and you're ready to go. So, but before I render stuff, I'm going to show you the ribbon control. So ribbon control I'm getting here. So ribbon control, basically I built, as you can see here, so all redo, undo. So this can be heading font size. So all of these options are available in the ribbon control. So if you factored more, what you can do is basically create some use rooster or some other hooks, and then pass this information from your web part. So your web part doesn't know about any of those implementation of the rooster. So you can basically build that way as well. And that's what I did for my clients as well. So this is what we, and these are the ribbon controls. If I can show you all of a couple of them from here. So for example, if I go to align center button, so when it get clicked, we get set alignment API functions from the RoosterJS, and then it basically base because the center line and passing the center, it is aligned center. And then these are the out of the box, like a block code, etc. But here I want to show you the insert link. So look, if you insert link, because this is the custom thing I built on top of that, so API, it gives you just API, but doesn't give you any kind of the dialogue or any UI behind it. So what I did is I built my own, so I can show you shortly. So yeah, this is how I build all the controls, and then I pass this control to my ribbon, so your ribbon can render that. So if I go back and go into this ribbon control again, sorry, let me just click here. Okay, here. So now we're going to go to ribbon control, we're passing the editor, we're passing the control, some handlers, and some plugins. So if I go in here, so what I'm doing is I'm going through all my control and I'm rendering here. So for example, if it's a source code, I build a separate source code dialog. And then if it's a link or if it's a separator, a toggle, then all the toggle will go into this one. And if there's a no drop down, will go in here. And if it's a button, it will just go in here. So that way you can just keep adding your control. And if there's any control does not meet any of those types, you can add your own one. So if I go into, for example, I mean, if it's that buttons or downloads, they can the API is being called where we have defined the controls. But when in terms of the insert link popover, we can go into a separate component. And what happened here is it's just simple popover came up, and then we handle the submit. We will put the text, we put the URL, and then we call this insert link. And the insert link is under the Rooster API, one of the function. So you pass the data, pass the URL and display text, it will create a link for you. So simple is that. And same way I did the source code as well, source code dialog. So you create a dialog, and once you're ready, then you there is a method called editor format content, and then you get the latest, allow some other additional allowed tags. For example, iframe, you want to allow the iframe. By default, it's not allowed iframe, but you can use additional allowed tags to enable this. And then you go ahead and save in the model due to this format content model. So now if I go back to ribbon control, so it basically build your ribbon control like that, all of them. And I think if I see, is there any else? I think that's about it. And if I had initially, I had some issue with an insert link, was not working. So I had to bring down the code from the source code and to play around with it, debug it to make it work. But eventually I think it was working fine for me. So yeah, that's all from me. And if we going back to the presentation, I think the couple of things which if I show you as the next steps are, so I think what you could do is basically you can integrate this with your line of business really, really easily because you have a full control. For example, SharePoint list, you can bring the attach the SharePoint list and show any data for any column within the rich text editor from the dropdown. And then you can build the preview functionality, AI assistant you can integrate, and source code I've just built on the last night, so I will be adding into the next release as well. That's all from me. If you have any question, please.